Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Vika, and today we're gonna see what you need to know about your situation. So let's have a look. We're gonna choose three cards from this Crystals the Stone deck. Well, you have already seen them on the thumbnail picture, but for me it's a surprise what we're gonna have today. Okay, this one volunteered, the first one. Kunzeit, Kunzeit, Kunzeit. Okay. This pink stone, which is gonna be for pile number one. Number two, we will have this one. This is emerald. Oh yeah, this emerald looks weird. I think it's a raw natural emerald. Yeah, it's emerald. For pile number two. Okay, and pile number three. Oh, this is beautiful. Opal. And I'm gonna read in each reading already energies of these stones for you to understand if it's really your pile. And don't worry if you're confused with choice. Is my intuition showing me the right pile or not? I'm gonna also use in the beginning of each option this healing light Lenormand, for it to show us what is the situation, what is your situation or your current state, something about you, for you to recognize, is this my pile or not. And now we have our traditional sound cleansing. So guys, please be mindful if you're wearing headphones. There's going to be three loud sounds with this bowl. It's gonna be loud and it's gonna vibrate. That's why I love it. Let's start. Okay, and let's start our reading. Okay guys, pile number one, you chose this kunzite. Let's have a quick read here. What's this stone? What's it all about? Since it's pink, so it gives me some heart chakra vibes, some unconditional love vibes. And yes, it is, well, I was just working a lot with this deck, so I pretty much remember everything. Open up your love channel. Okay. A high vibe, lithium infused lilac pink stone that glows with an energy that could be described in a word as cuddly. Oh, cuddly. Who needs it? Anyone with a heavy heart about something. Collectors of good vibrations. Where to put it? A place on your heart and breathe deeply of Kunzeit's cotton candy essence. Or hold in your left hand and whisper sweet nothings to yourself. When to use it? Call on Kunzeit after a breakup or a major disappointment, or when you're beating yourself up about something. You don't need permission to be here. You belong. If you forget that, pause, tap into Kunzeit pink prismatic vibration and let love rule. Woohoo! Okay, so if it says something about your situation, this is your reading. If not, try another pile, please. Okay, and now let's get a card from Lenormand to double check what's this situation here under consideration, and you will be sure if it's your reading or if it's not. Okay, this one. Sun. Okay. Well, sun is a symbol of success, clarity, and it's also masculine energy. Well, so this rather tells me about a situation connected with success, with the outer world, like some social popularity, some success, so some masculine energy rather inside of you, even if you're feminine, like you're masculine, you're active, you're more domineering side than inner side. So either this is love reading and this is about a situation about clarity in some regarding some masculine energy, this might also be, or this is about right success, like happy period in your life. Okay. So yeah, let's see. I'm gonna use today. I don't remember actually, because this deck lives in a little beautiful bag. I think it's witchcraft deck. I mean, special bag for this deck. I mean, maybe you know it. I already don't remember what's its name, but I know that this deck is super powerful. Okay, so first question is, what are your feelings about this situation? Okay, this one, justice. This card is actually not about feelings at all. This card is about being rational, about being unbiased, very sober, rationally thinking, almost like in a detached way. So as if the situation is not regarding you yourself, but like someone else. So very, like, this is a very good actually mode for taking decisions, this justice. Okay, let me just grab another deck when I want to see your emotions. Psychic Tarot. I will take Psychic Tarot. We'll clarify a bit. This is throat chakra. This is chakra of truth, of communications, of course, and truth, and together with the justice. So I really like how we get like double message is actually something toxic. same message twice. So it's like confirmation. Come on. So yes, this is a very truthful, actually not emotional, but very transparent way of seeing your situation. Okay. All right, guys. Pile number one. Let's see. I have this question. How accurate is your view of the situation? But I mean, I think... Oh, okay. Actually, interesting. All these cards came together. So there was these two together and after the Chariot. So it's actually Nine of Swords, Eight of Pentacles, and the Chariot. Well, anyway, a little bit tainted with... Okay, I was too quick. Jumping to conclusions. Okay, so this is actually might be very logical, very unemotional, very much based on your previous experiences, because Eight of Pentacles, it's our experience, it's something we experienced many times, something we know well, so it's like a practical knowledge. Okay, and Nine of Swords, so there's some fears behind, like from the past, but anyway, this your attitude, like it's a very ambiguous energy here. I'm gonna clarify, don't worry. Chariot is actually very driven, a very active, ready to conquer energy. So most probably it feels like you are kind of being super careful, like too much, let's say. I mean, in your situation, if it takes you to this result as Chariot, so it makes you actually work harder or be more active or try harder, like do your best maximum, because you're slightly afraid here. I will clarify if it's like okay, normal or not, but yeah, a bit of Eight of Cups, Eight of Swords. Actually, this deck is so beautiful with all this. Unfortunately, you cannot see it because this, my front camera is not the best one. Okay. Yeah, so like a bit, you see, a bit distorted vision of this situation, but basically these fears, this anxiety and worry, you know, a little bit of worry. I'm revising my Reiki course now, and which I did like few years ago, I think during quarantine, but now I felt an urge, like, hey, yeah, I want to revise it, I want to do it actually. And there was this like hands position for worry, and there was a little like the teacher were telling us about worry, so a little bit of worry, a little bit, is actually good because it motivates you. So it's not that terrible, it's not that cool to be always chilled and always relaxed. You know, just a little bit of worry actually makes you kick your ass, like here. Yeah, but let's see if this Nine of Swords, it's something which is in your way. You need to do something about it. You need to calm down, because sometimes these actually darker energies, they are motivating us. King of Swords, Five of Swords, King of Wands. Okay, so this is how they work. They make you more determined. They make you more active. But Five of Swords, I don't like it. It's like you're ready to lose already. Okay, so yeah, we're gonna clarify this. Your attitude is very then rational. So okay, throat chakra is actually about truth. So yeah, I see that this is truth. Your reaction on the situation is truth, but it's based on some intellectual perception, like what happened to you or some of your maybe friends, family, like some kind of knowledge. Maybe with throat chakra, it's something which has been told to you or something you have been telling someone, you know, like some intellectual knowledge. So it's being very rational. Okay, sorry, it's not about transparency, but this is like not about intuition, actually. Well, something you're worried about, something. So maybe you're feeling it, actually, maybe it's your intuition telling you like, hey, it's gonna be a rocky road. Sometimes it's okay, you know, we cannot have everything super easy, but because we're not gonna appreciate it. Okay, so I'm gonna clarify. Let's use again this psychic tarot. How accurate is your view of the situation? Well, actually, look. Yeah, there is Nine of Swords because there is a warrior. Maybe this Eight of Pentacles. It's either your previous experience or too much work put into something and now you're waiting. So it's like, it feels like you're gambling. Like, I don't know, I win or lose. But you're basically ready. Okay, now... Triumph, again Chariot. So you see Chariot twice. So it makes you, it gives you this drive, this energy, desire to overcome. So basically it's like sometimes you need to get really pissed in order to conquer something. So this is your case. But yeah, so a bit like tainted with fierce perception, but it's actually good for you. Okay, so this first position with Justice, like, yeah, fair enough, you see the situation. Fulfillment of wishes, Nine of Cups. Okay, now I think it's actually okay, truth. Okay, truth is Judgment card here. So basically, when you guys will see the truth, what happens, okay, new beginnings, yeah, then you will chill, relax, and be emotionally withdrawn, finally. But now you cannot just, it's something really, okay, Ace of Pentacles, prosperity begins, something really important for you. Feels like it's rather about business, success, yeah, the Sun card is talking about this, being also like visible, shining, radiating. Okay, what else we have? How can you better understand the situation? So now, like, little adjustment if possible. Let's see, how can you better understand the situation? Wheel of fortune. What wheel of the year here? It's called wheel of the year here. I like how the deck is painted, which is so beautiful. The Empress. Oh, okay. I don't feel like it's how can you better, because your perception, yeah, it's slightly like worried, but here in your situation, it actually makes you move. Like, do your best, right? Like, show your best qualities. I understand that. Sometimes it's like with finances. So if you have like a certain, like little bit of financial need, you're not like completely desperate. So it's much more motivating than you have a lot of money on your account and you're like, oh, you know, I cannot go to work. I can, you know, especially if you're self-employed, you're like, maybe today I'm going to have a vacation. I don't know. So yeah, it's a bit of worry, a bit of lack, actually. It's a very motivating force. So these are all major arcanas. So this is about spiritual perception. But first one is Wheel of Fortune. So Wheel of Fortune would be telling us about cycles. Like there's time to play and there is time to work, right? So now time to work. So you're doing everything right. So the only advice from Spirit is like, this gonna pass too, like what was written on King Solomon's ring. This gonna pass too. Whether it's a bad day or a good day, it's gonna pass. So we always go through cycles, up and down, up and down, up and down. So yeah, just this cycle now. And yeah, basically this little bit of worry is actually motivating for you. Yeah, just repeating it again, sorry. But just really look at the cards and feel the message. The Empress and the Strength, both very feminine archetypes, motherly, abundant, and creative energy, and this power of resilience with compassion. So being resilient, not give up, test of a character, but it's not about like this, you know, like rough power, strength, like, you know, breaking everything around, you know, connected with ego, who's the strongest here, but it's a power of character. Basically, really, it's connected rather with passion, passion towards something you're doing. Compassion, I wanted to say passion, compassion, and God, there was another word, it's like, not patience, but yeah, let it be patience, okay, whatever, patience. Okay, so these are, but it's like a more feminine strength, so it's not the very brutal force, yeah, not brutal force, but very soft energy, inner energy. Yeah, okay, so let's get an advice from Moonology here. The answers you need are coming. Okay. And yeah, surrender to the divine. So basically, you're in the right flow. So what you're doing is okay. Just try to maybe relax more. But this, okay, just cannot let go this. Nine of Swords. I want to do something about the Nine of Swords. Let me take my astrological cards. So maybe let's... Descendant invitation. Okay. And sixth house, house of job, work, sustainability, everyday business, Venus, beloved. Okay. Changing your job for something you really love. And this is the Warrior. And you were working a lot on that. Okay, but what should you do with the Nine of Swords? Maybe. Okay. Power. Control your fears. You cannot control, understand them. And release them. Yeah, so this is about controlling. This is about your connection with the divine, the crown chakra. So try some meditations. Yeah, look, spiritual strength with Nine of Wands. So yeah, guys, try to... this, like, a certain need, it motivates you. How is it... this quote, how it sounds... pain is inevitable, suffering is optional. So yeah, this is some kind of... I feel some pressure in this reading, so it's like either little time, like some deadline you have, or some kind of pressure which makes you go faster. So this is okay, but you should perceive it with positivity, right? At least try to do that. Okay, what should you guys do? Well, number one, to move forward. Ten of Cups! Be absolutely happy and fulfilled. Fill your life with positive emotions, positive people. Yeah, look, all the emotions. Three of Cups, Two of Cups. Guys, don't close off yourself from emotions because you perceive the situation very logically. You underestimate in this pile. That's why you had this pink, you were drawn subconsciously, intuitively to this pink stone, because this is something you lack actually now. And look, Fool, some lightness, some lightheartedness. Two of Cups, Three of Cups, Ten of Cups, friends, beloved, connections, you know, freedom, like time to work and time to play. So you need to include some emotions into your life. Basically, it's not about like making decisions in emotional state. No, this is about, okay, you kind of forgot about emotions, having fun, enjoying life. Remember, you live only once. Don't forget your beloved people. Okay. What should you do to move forward? Symbiosis. This can actually talk about the trine or sextile card. Wow, this deck is so beautiful. Symbiosis. Yeah, connections with other people, friends, maybe teamwork. So maybe you need to ask some advice. So you're trying to do everything. Like, yeah, I'm gonna do it. I don't need you. Don't distract me. But actually, some people will help you, and the answers you need are coming. So maybe through someone from your circle. So it can be like. For many of you, it's different. For some of you, it's family member. For some of you, it's a friend. For some of you, it's a colleague. For some of you, it's your partner or lover. So some answers are coming from people. So don't close off. And let's get another piece of advice. This is Work Your Light and Starseed Oracle. Oracles. Yeah, I saw, yes. Soul family, call in your tribe. You don't have to do it alone. Fantastic. And let's get another one. I can never limit myself to one card. Star Mother, how can you mother yourself? Yeah, give yourself some emotions. Keepers of the Earth. You are not alone. Again, listen, again, not you're not alone. And you shouldn't be alone. And you shouldn't be too rigid here. Ancient ancestors stand beside you. Yeah, guys, so you need to calm down your emotions through adding some positive emotions from people you love, you like, you respect. Cool, guys. Thank you so much for being here. Don't forget about a private reading giveaway. I'm going to link a video somewhere there. And also there's information written in the description down below if you click it. And I see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye. Hi, guys. Pile number two. You chose this emerald stone. This is how it looks. Let's have a read what they say here about energy of this stone. Maybe it will tell you something about your situation so you will understand if it's your reading or it's your option or not. Emerald, point your heart towards grace. What is it? One of the four precious gemstones, emerald radiates with a wet, lush, verdant energy. Historically, emerald is associated with love, beauty, and sex. Okay, that's something we like on this channel. So if you're into any of that, you might want to associate yourself with this saturated green gem. I like it. Who needs it? Aestheticists, sorry for my pronunciation. Bohemians, Epicureans, Transcendentalists. All of us here, definitely. Okay, where to put it? On a chain over your heart or on a ring at the base of your left thumb, perched atop the Venus mount. Okay. Really? Left thumb? Here? This is Venus mount? Oh, wow. I didn't know that. When to use it? When you've temporarily lost the courage to love and be loved. When you're in need of a total refresh, open your heart to limitless possibility with emerald. Okay. What a wonderful stone. Cool. So second stone is about love energy. Love is all you need. Okay. So now I'm going to take a card from this Healing Light Lenormand. Again, to double check if it's your situation. It's not. So, dear spirit, what is our situation under consideration? Ring. Okay, so it's a relationship. Well, it might be contract of some kind, so any kind of relationship. But bottom of the deck energy, I have heart, ring, emotions, relationships, and this crossroads. So it's like a decision about relationship. Okay, so this is pretty straightforward, and with our emerald energy. Yep, okay, so this is relationship-oriented reading, emotions, yeah, definitely. Okay, so I'm gonna take my witchcraft. Actually, I'm not sure if it's called witchcraft. I think it's witchcraft, yeah, witchcraft tarot. Because this deck, she lives in this wonderful bag, especially for this, and I don't remember the name anymore. Okay, our first question is, what are your feelings about the situation? Nine of Wands. You feel very guarded. You feel very suspicious. You've experienced a lot in your life, maybe of some troublesome relationships, and you're very, very vigilant. You're not gonna give yourself away, give your heart away that easily. Or maybe something happened, something triggered you, like some maybe a red flag or some kind of conflict or whatever with your person. Or this is about, in general, about relationships. Like I want a new relationship, but I feel a bit guarded. So I don't want to let anyone into my life. I want to see what are they about. Okay, death. Look, death and Ace of Wands. This is about, maybe it's a decision, because we saw the crossroads card there, so it might be about the decision. Should I give it a new go? Should I end it? Or should I start it anew, and or should I end this and start something new? There's a lot of thoughts about this, and what I see here, 10 of Wands, a lot of stress about this situation. Should I end? Should I start something new? Should I give this a second chance? What should I do? But you feel guarded. Okay, I'm gonna clarify your feelings about the situation with my psychic tarot. Okay, this one. Love begins. Oh, okay, you feel guarded, but there is certain invitation for, and actually this card, this Ace of Cups, has to be called Love Begins in this deck. You see? Okay, conflict and defeat. Okay, some conflict. Huh, let me maybe clarify, because I don't really understand. What's this? Is this about Love Begins? It's about new situation for you, or about this person you want to end things with, or... Okay, Five of Wands, this is your person. And new person, Six of Cups. Okay, so definitely, what should you do? Let's quickly get an advice for you from Spirit. What should you do about this, something you want to end, like maybe an past person or current partner you're thinking about, like divorcing or breaking up with them? Justice. Okay, justice is a pretty logical decision. So everything you see, it's visible to your eyes, logically, rationally. So this is, you have all the information to take the decision. So something is not working, so you have to just adjust your actions. If someone gives you red flags constantly, you should just act upon it. So something you already decided, you had all the evidence. I mean, with justice, you want to start talking like you're in a court. Yeah, so you have all the evidence to proceed with your actions. So now we're gonna have a look. How accurate is your view of the situation? That you're being slightly guarded now. Seven of Swords. Okay, well, this is Wheel of Fortune and Two of Cups. Okay, let me just clarify this. So this past person, I feel like there's like a few people here involved, definitely like someone new. I'm not sure, you, some of you maybe have already met this person, some of you maybe didn't, but there's like definitely, okay, lovers and Ace of Swords and Ace of Pentacles, guys, this is definitely about a new person. So what it seems like here, there's some kind of Seven of Swords, how accurate you perceive, and this is like kind of deception card replying this question. So, you know, it's like not really correct, but I mean, let me understand what is your feelings. Okay, so if you're basically this card is telling, no, you're perceiving the situation wrong. If you decided like, okay, this person did, like your current or like last partner you had, like someone, I mean, like if you have this decision, I will be guarded from everyone, from just everyone, because this past person, they pissed me off. I don't want to be dealing with men or women anymore again, humans at all. So this is completely wrong. You're being totally emotional now. You're being defensive. This is understandable. You just, you know, going through the phase of grieving. That's okay. But what is shown here, this dark period of your life, like unlucky, let's call it, will be over. But actually, I feel like it will be over with this past person, so you would rather need to get rid of them. Yeah, so basically your decision on past person, like the last emotionally disappointing situation in your personal life, yes, you're absolutely right about that person, but you're not right about not giving a chance to someone new. About like, if you decided that, hey, I'm not lucky in love, actually it's a topic for a next reading, for one of the few next readings, why am I not lucky in love? I'm gonna put it down. So yeah, if you decided I'm not lucky in love, I'm just gonna close myself off from everyone. So no, because there's a really destined partner coming to you, soulmate, definitely. With Two of Cups, there's gonna be a lot of positive emotions, feelings, mutual love, mutual care. So, and this is someone new. Look, lovers. So this is a meaningful relationship, definitely. Definitely mutual attraction. Definitely you will feel it. You will feel this is your person. And look, Ace of Swords and Ace of Pentacles. This is definitely someone new coming. So this is not the past person. Okay, let me just clarify how accurate is your... We will take Astro cards. Star quotes, Astro Oracle. Let's see how accurate is your view of the situation. Pile two, seventh house, relationship. That's very kept and obvious. Thank you, Spirit. Opposition, confrontation. Well, seventh house is actually the house which is opposite the first one. So yeah, it's kind of correct. But yeah, I mean, relationships and opposition. So it's like... me against relationships. So basically a very anti-relationship attitude. So this attitude is kind of wrong for you. Let's not make this reading super long. The Spirit is saying that's wrong. There's some tension because opposition is aspect of tension. It's a tensed aspect which basically makes us kind of let something go. So we need to sacrifice something. Well, definitely let's sacrifice your past person. That's it. Not the future. Future loves. Mm-hmm. So yeah, and confrontation with these... Oh, look at these deers here fighting. So yeah, it's like the conflict which made you perceive all the relationship in general, like bad, like everyone. Putting everyone in one basket. So yeah, okay. Not really. not really accurate is your perception of the situation. How could you better understand this situation? Okay, I saw the star there, but now it's not getting out, but I anyway saw it. Okay. Nine of Swords. So okay, look, Seven of Wands, this defensive energy, Four of Cups and Nine of Swords. I'm just going to clarify, what should you do with all these energies? For me, it's with the star, it's actually releasing them. So let yourself heal, let yourself release all what you need, but do it naturally. So maybe take time with yourself. Yeah, you definitely need to take care of your Four of Cups. It's actually going within, going inside, analyzing your feelings, being present. It's not really like analyzing and judging yourself for feelings, but actually this defenseless, maybe like a short period of being defensive against this person will not harm you, but you know, there's something new new coming to you. So yeah, wouldn't be, yeah, Ace, yeah, I just saw, look, Ace of, look at that, Ace of Cups and the Empress, something new definitely coming towards you. I'm just gonna check out what should you do, because Seven of Wands and Nine of Swords are pretty like negative, conditionally I will say negative energies. So definitely it's not advice, it's addressing to your fears and your defensiveness. Okay, Seven of Wands, let's clarify Seven of Wands. How could you better understand the situation? Okay, obstacles and challenges. Okay, you know what, like something which didn't happen with this person, it's just not your person, this past one, it's not the new one. So yeah, obstacles and challenges are there for a reason. So maybe you needed, through some toxicity, you needed to see your own shadow side, you know, they had to trigger you for you to understand something, or maybe, you know, how it happens, like you need to break up with this person just to meet the new one. And, you know, you learned something, and look, choose wisely. So maybe it was a lesson in, like, you saw red flags, but you didn't act upon it. And now you see, yeah, I was right. So, you know, now you don't have to blame yourself. It's just a mistake. First of all, we should all learn how to forgive ourselves. Nine of Swords, authority. Okay, so yeah. Your fears, your anxieties should be under control. Authority. It's like authority of fear. But I remember I had in one deck, there's a fear, soul journey lesson cards. Actually, it's there. There's fear card, and there's like, I admit that I fell into energy of fear, but I commit to energy of love, something like that. Kind of, I understand that I was in under the influence of my fears, but now I'm just going in the right direction. Yeah, so basically understanding that you have nothing to worry about, you have nothing to be afraid of. There's someone new coming. Yes, and look, Tower, Five of Cups. And Tower is actually, look, fantastic. Tower is actually a card which is, yeah, it's a shocking, it's a destructive event, something which we perceived as something forever. Maybe you thought this past person is like the one, right? And here you have this shock, you're disappointed, you lost them, you lost your faith, they did something completely unacceptable, a deal breaker. For this reason, so it's basically meant to be, so this is like divine intervention. For you to take the decision, King of Swords, be determined to cut them off. And this Three of Pentacles here is actually telling me that you were working on something. So definitely there was, that might be like a karmic connection, this past one. So you need to think what that person actually gave you. Sometimes those people who do bad stuff towards us, actually they open our eyes on our own, either shadow side or weaknesses, like anything. And actually it's a huge present if you think, like, if not that toxic person, I wouldn't learn this about myself, I wouldn't become better, and I wouldn't be with this better person today. So yeah, so now you just need to release the emotions. Four of Cups, yeah, just stay a bit in your own space, you know, take care of yourself. This is not really about going super active, this is just about dealing with your fears, with your perception of obstacles. Okay, Four of Cups, moving on. Yeah, give yourself a bit time and you will see that you will release all the emotions. Yeah, the waiting game. Yeah, and don't be in a hurry here. Don't be in a hurry. Your person is coming when you're ready. And they're not coming before you're ready. Okay. This was, yeah, how how can I better... Okay, excuse me. A sip of my tea. Perfect. What should you do to move forward? Actually, we finished this question on moving on. What should you do to move on? Okay. Well, there's a death card already, but we'll see. I'm going to shuffle it anyway. What should you do to... Oops. Okay, something's falling out. Four of Pentacles. Okay, but this is actually, you know what? This is actually very much, again, what should you do to move on? This is very much resonating with the energy in the beginning. Well, there is a certain difference here. So Four of Pentacles, it's keeping yourself a bit guarded. So this is like a really defensive, like, look at this lady. She's like, if you are approaching me, I'm going to beat you up with this wand, with these nine wands. So it's like even being aggressive, like being very... very defensive, like you don't know who is approaching you with which intentions, but you are like already ready to attack them. So this attitude is full of resentment. You will release emotions and you will see that you feel better, and you know, there's certain feelings. So they're like, this was the first question, what are your feelings about the situation? So basically there's like, yes, I want this new beginning, but I feel very there's a lot of resentment on this past person. Also, what you can do, there's a cool psychological technique. You can like write them a goodbye letter. You write it on paper and after you burn it, so you don't have to like send it definitely to the person, and you put everything, all your negative emotions, everything, like you can use like swear words, aggression, let yourself be frustrated, aggressive, disappointed, everything. Set timer for an hour. You do this 1 hour, not like 5 minutes or something. Put some like sad music. I usually like to use some like without words, or something like, you know, like this sad Gregorian chants or something, like something kind of sad, but better without words, because it's going to distract you. I mean, if it doesn't distract you, that's fine. So, I mean, like even Adele, Rolling in the Deep. Yeah, so you will release it. And this is actually, what should you do? Three of Swords. So it's, again, about addressing this Three of Swords, not ignoring, like everything is fine. No, this something which hurts you, the pain, you need to address it. You need to work on it. okay, understand why and how can you heal yourself, basically. Four of Pentacles, actually, with this, if we compare with this Nine of Wands, it's like, okay, if you approach me, I'm going to attack you. And this one is like, I'm just not giving you straight away my Pentacles, right? So my treasures I have. So it's like keeping your treasures to yourself and basically move forward. Like, you know what, guys? Here it's... And next one we have King of Pentacles and bottom of the deck energy, also Seven of Pentacles. So give yourself time and take time. It's actually reminding me, I have a spread. I try not to forget to link it. Reconnecting with your sexuality. And there was a spread, I don't remember which one. But anyway, you should choose your pile with your intuition and not with my tips and prompts. There was something about slowing down and not like kind of jumping into sexual connection right away. So this is like a problem to be patient, like a lesson to be patient. This very, very much reminds me of that energy to be patient and be kind of guarded, but like, you know, not closed off, not aggressive towards anyone who's approaching you to inquire if you're looking for a relationship, but just like, yeah, I'm looking for a relationship. And you're like, you know, you're not moving towards them. Because most probably in this pile, you're very active. If something begins, you're super active. And you're like, yeah, you're this most probably Queen of Wands, Ace of Wands here. Yeah, so you're very swiftly, you're like, yeah, let's do it. Let's get this relationship done. And after, you feel frustrated. But here, the secret is like, first, you know, take care of yourself, be in your secure comfort zone. Actually, here in this pile, this advice is everywhere. This advice, yeah, step out of your comfort zone. Here, get back to your comfort zone. And this, basically, your person, if you're looking for a masculine, right? If you're waiting for a masculine person, oh, doesn't matter, it's gender neutral reading, King of Pentacles. So someone who's actually has something to offer, a provider, a very caring person. King of Pentacles, they might be like too, you know, practical and down to earth and like a bit boring, like phlegmatic temperament, so kind of like very calm, but it's a person you can count on, definitely someone for a serious relationship. Okay, so now I'm gonna ask a piece of advice from Moonology and from Work Your Light and Starseed Oracles. Okay, let's see. What should you do to move forward? Look at the bigger picture. Exactly, this is what we were doing here. Look at the bigger picture. So don't look at something like, oh, they offended me. That was for a reason for you to get rid of that person because a new person is coming. Like, in briefly speaking. Okay, maybe something else. Yeah, don't let pride get in your way. Mm-hmm. So this is actually about this, like, how dare you to do this? I'm going to revenge on you with some other people. No, please don't do it, because it's going to be actually traumatizing to yourself in first place. Okay. All right. So we have a few cards. Oh, yes. And bottom of the deck energy. Look at this. Wait, it's not yet time. Things are being woven. So yeah, your person is coming. But wait, please. Okay, loosen your grip, coping mechanisms, density, addiction, let God in. Coping mechanisms and loosen your grip, right? It's this one. Messenger, bringing harmony and balance. Empathetic starseed. Oh, hi, starseeds. Welcome to our community. Energetic sovereignty, absorbing what's not yours. Yeah. So yeah, you need some good emotional detox because you grabbed some others people's emotions and you need just to release it to stay in your safe, secure zone, and your person is coming. But don't wait for it, please. Just, you know, enjoy your own company here. Okay, guys, thank you so much, pile number two. This is what you needed to know on your situation. I hope it helped. Please have a look at the description box. I have information on private reading giveaway for my subscriber number 500. Also, I will link somewhere here the video about where I explain what to do, how to get your reading if you're my subscriber number 500. So yeah, guys, have a good day, have a good night. I see you in the next one. Bye. Okay, pile number three. Hello and welcome to your reading. You chose this opal stone. Let's read what this card says here about this stone. Maybe this energy of the stone will explain you something about your situation, resemble you the situation, and this way you will know this is your reading. Okay, feel all your feels, opal. What is it? Opals are well-hydrated, amorphous mineraloids. Precious opals are lusted after for their rainbow sparkle, aka diffraction. Common opals form in a range of colors and can deliver sensations that are anything but common. Who needs it? The all-black wardrobe set can benefit from black precious opals' bold pop of color and spiritual protection. Not-so-prolific artists can ride fire opals burn. Where to put it? General rule, white and blue wipe with the head, pink wipes with the heart, and black wipes with the lower abdomen. Okay. When to use it? When you have something that needs to get moving, a project, a relationship, an energetic block. Okay. And let's double check your situation with Lenormand. This is Healing Light Lenormand. So let's see what's your guy's situation. Pile three. Okay. what did you say? To have something that needs to get moving. This is anchor. This is something which is not moving. Well, typically in letter. Maybe you're waiting for some papers, for some documents, for some confirmations, approvals, whatever. This might be about job. So normally, classically in Lenormand, anchor card is about stable job, but it's like, you know, job employment. It's not about like, you know, success, your own business, something very stable. And sometimes it's like chore, you know, like chores, right? So kind of something I have to do, like sixth house in astrology. So yeah, something which is not moving. A job, potentially, something you're stuck in with. So yeah, and there's some waiting for some information, official information, documents, papers, paperwork being done, you know, depending on someone, like maybe a boss. Maybe you're waiting for a raise or to be transferred to, you know, other location, or you want to get hired. Maybe. Yeah, I said like, yeah, because there was a fox and a key. Key and a fox. Fox is actually someone, an employee. Someone employed. Okay, so let's have a look then. Let's have a look. If this is resonating with your situation, this is your reading then. If no, please try another pile, not to cram your head with some information which you don't need. We live in such a time of informational chaos, so we have too much information all around. Okay, what are your feelings, guys, about your situation? Let's see. I'm using this witchcraft tarot today. What are your guys' feelings? Seven of Cups. Well, okay, trying to guess what's gonna happen. Lost in choices, lost in illusions, lost in dreams and visualizations, visions of future and past and scenarios, what might happen. The death. What are your feelings, God? You're ready for something to be over. Mm-hmm. A lot of emotions. Seven of Cups, it's a lot of emotions and imagination. And death, like these are either very strong, passionate feelings, or you feel like ending something, or it depends like on your situation. If you're afraid that something's gonna end, so you're visualizing that, oh no, it's gonna end, or if you want to start moving somewhere, because this anchor means that you were sitting somewhere for a long time and you want to change it, so it means like you want it, so you're basically your perception of reality is slightly distorted towards something you actually want, right? So like you don't see the reality as it is, but you see something what you want to see, actually. Mm-hmm. King of Pentacles here. Okay, bottom of the deck energy, King of Pentacles. King of Pentacles. Maybe also some kind of figure you're dependent on, like a boss, or it's you and your financial issues. Ten of Pentacles here, okay. Money issues. So this situation is rather about job, money, as far as I can see. Okay, let's clarify. I'm using also a psychic tarot here to get one card to see what are your feelings about this situation. Oh, okay, victory and success. Wait a second. So victory and success. But this, I noticed already that in this reading of previous two piles, this deck is showing more 5D level and this is more 3D level. So this is how decks work sometimes. And okay, so actually, okay, we're gonna clarify it. We're gonna ask the second question. How accurate is your view of situation? Let's see. Because Seven of Cups, it's already some imaginative, illusionary vision, perception, right? Eight of Swords. This card is very beautiful, but come on, it's still Eight of Swords. It's imposter syndrome. It's analysis paralysis. So it's basically, I can do nothing. So you're imagining yourself being powerless. So this is like a powerless position. Kind of a little bit of victim mode. So it's happening to me, but I have no power over it. Queen of Swords and Strength. Well, with, you know, Eight of Swords, look, her eyes are, she's blindfolded. So basically it's how accurate? Well, I don't think it's accurate, actually. We're gonna have a look how you can better understand the situation. It's more from some kind of power position. So you see more aggression towards you. For example, what I see here, it's like you're envisioning that your boss is gonna fire you. While they're super happy about you, you know, like seeing the worst scenario, kind of searching for something you need to fight against, like this kind of a bit like aggressive, defensive perception here in this pile. I'm gonna clarify it with astrological deck. How accurate is your perception? Fourth house, home. And South Node past. Or also, you know what, Queen of Swords, this can be a mother figure. So somehow maybe you're under influence of opinion of your mother, because this might be also Queen of Swords. It's someone, someone very smart, intellectual, but they also might be very negative, you know, and unemotional and kind of, you know, definitely your perception is the first one, your feelings, like it's illusions, already illusions. So it's like maybe someone is telling you some stories like, oh, life is so tough, you know, this kind of way. So more negative perception than it should be, definitely. And this past and South Node and fourth house, both of them are like talking about the same thing, the South Node and the fourth house. So it's like our roots. So that's why I see that maybe it's actually influence from at least, you know, maybe it's not influence from your family, a mother figure. Something you got used to, you know, like some old attitude, like basically not thinking out of the box, but definitely thinking out of the box. Yes, no, not out of the box, but inside of the box. I don't know if this phrase works, vice versa, but I made it. I created it. Okay. How could you better understand the situation? Okay, this microphone is actually slightly in my way here. How could you better understand the situation? Let's see, pile three. Okay, Six of Cups, positive emotions in the studio, please. King of Wands. Okay, King of Wands. Well, if there's some figure, like, you know, maybe at your workplace or somewhere in your life, there are people like, this is either a fire sign, because there was some kind of King of Pentacles, or which might be an earth sign, and this is a fire sign, might be, or this is talking about your model of behavior, pattern of behavior, more charismatic, more self-assured. And basically this card is like 5D level, showed success and victory. This is also Wands, this is Six of Wands. So basically, kind of somewhere deep inside, you understand, your higher self understands that you will be victorious and successful, but your rational mind keeps on created this horrible stories, like how everything will collapse, everything will be bad, you will get fired, you will never succeed, and something, and so on. And this is past energy for you, so you need to overcome it, definitely. Okay, so how could you better understand King of Swords? Okay, so more passion, more charismatic, self-assured energy, and more determination here. So basically not imagining things before you see facts. Before you, like, okay, don't think about getting fired before actually you got fired. Okay, this is a joke. Thank you, Spirit, for the joke. It's funny. Okay, Six of Cups. But you know what? Six of Cups, this home, past, mother figure here, maybe. Guys, maybe you need, if you're like in therapy, you're healing something, it's not that you have to start it because of tarot reading, but I mean, if you feel, why not? If you feel like it. This might be, Six of Cups is also about inner child, like past, actually healing your inner child. What are these King of Wands, I wonder, and King of Swords? Okay, King of Wands. I added clarified King of Wands with Five of Swords. Well, like taking any, if there's a job which like you're getting fired, perceive it as a success. Like, okay, finally, Dobby is free and I can go somewhere. And King of Swords, yeah, taking a decision that maybe, so, I mean, feels like maybe you were desiring to move from like, it's like an example what I feel the energy here. Maybe it's just a bit different from your situation. So like you were longing for to leave this job, but you could never do it because like, hey, it's financially stable. Am I stupid? Like just to quit my job and go somewhere. So basically it's like perceiving any loss and any defeat as actually a boost, a motivation to move further, to take a decision. Okay, so this is my time to move. So this is a sign of universe that I need to move. Yeah, okay. Ah, look at that. How cool is that? The world, the cycle is complete. This is over, but peacefully, you know, peacefully. Yeah, that's over. You don't have to be afraid. And Ace of Wands and Ace of Swords, something new coming. It's just, this is interesting how it's, I'm not sure, maybe these opportunities will come actually for some people you know or you don't yet know, because this is King of Wands and this is Ace of Wands. This is King of Swords and this is Ace of Swords. It's like, maybe there will be like even two opportunities, which one, like one will be more speaking to your rational mind. Okay, this looks better. And this one is like something you will want more. So instead of this, your situation, yeah, look at that. And also I hear here, this, I have here 10 of Wands, which is stress, a lot of anxiety, a lot, like heavy burden. And behind it is Ace of Pentacles. New opportunity, a lot of aces, something new is definitely coming. Okay, I'm gonna also clarify, what was it, how can you better understand the situation? Let's take Moonology, maybe. And we will have another question, what should you do to move forward? And that will be it on this situation. Okay, so how to better understand the situation? Your hard work is paying off, okay. And look at the bigger picture. Exactly. So yeah, don't look at some small details like, oh, I got fired. But like what it means from point of view of your whole life. So sometimes, you know, actually, or not getting a promotion, a raise, feeling like, you know, my hard work is not paying off. Maybe your hard work actually is supposed to be paid on a different, you know, they're not gonna give you a promotion and you're gonna find a new place. And all your experience, all your hard work will be accepted very well with applause in the new workplace, for example, like just example. So in any life situation, you can apply such a rule. Okay, how to better understand the situation. So, but actually this is super funny here, just a second, how like really these cards, like this psychic tarot shows me more 5D reality, I see that, and this witchcraft is more like down to earth 3D reality. So like your spirit is kind of about the situation, oh my god, thanks god, this is success, we are victorious. And your rational mind is like, oh no, oh my god, it's terrible, it's the end, it's the apocalypse. Okay, and the messages from Work Your Light and Starseed, actually this is Starseed here, The Cosmic Heart, Devotion, Potency, Make Your Life a Moving Prayer. This is an advice. How could you understand the situation better? We the Hathors, Deep Love, Mother's Milk, Birth as a Portal.
Oh! Oh!
Motherly Energy. I don't know, maybe because I had like this deck is here and I put rose quartz on top of it, so it attracted feminine energy. Ah, yeah, bottom of the deck energy, look. Crumbling. What are you clinging onto? So something which is getting ruined. Actually, this is like a tower energy for me. Something which has to be ruined, but of course we will not, because this is something, an anchor, something you get used to also, and it's like comfort zone. And say yes, just say yes to the changes. Okay, let's see, what should you do to move forward? Now we see the actions. Oh, wow. Oh, that's so cool. Yeah, bottom of the deck energy is still Five of Cups. So, yeah, there's this, you know, some kind of imagining that this is like the end of the world. Like, I understand. Like, in the moment, everyone is emotional. This is like your life when you're main hero of your own story. It's difficult to be super detached, you know. You're not crazy, that's fine. We are emotional beings, humans, so that's fine. But look, how should you act? The Hangman. Let go everything which is moving away from your life. Let it go, surrender to the divine. This is actually a non-action card, so let it be what should be. Okay, this is happening, I let this happen. After, look, we see, we have Ten of Pentacles. Whoa, this is abundance coming. So basically, really, it's like, this really feels like you're getting like fired somewhere, but you're finding a new job, actually, where you will be appreciated much more, and you will be happy that they fired you. Actually, you will be like, thank you so much. Thank you. Can't stand this place anymore. And the Star, new future, renewing, rejuvenating your energy, healing, having some rest. Maybe for some of you, actually, you know what, it's like for a certain time, I mean, hopefully it's not gonna sound terrible. I mean, especially if you have like some, because we had that motherly energy there, for some of you, actually, it's like becoming a mother and getting a baby. So for a moment, like, switching from career life to family life, or if you have like someone to provide for you, you know, like for a certain period of time, to stay at home and not work at all will be also healing for you. But this is like for some of you. Okay, so what should you do to move forward? Let's ask a piece of advice from Moonology. What do you need to release? And this is the Hangman energy. Yes, everything which is leaving you, don't hold to it. Just let it go. If it's leaving, especially now, that's just not yours anymore. Okay, and this one here, what should you do to move forward? Yes, just say yes again. Yes, just say yes. Okay, guys, pile number three. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please check out the description box below. There's information about private reading giveaway, and I will also hopefully not forget to link the video about it, a short video, what to do, how to send, where is my Instagram, and take a screenshot, and what to send me the screenshot. Okay, subscriber number 500 will get a private reading. Yes, guys, that's all from me. I wish you good luck with your situation, guys. I wish you good night or good day whenever you're watching, and I see you in the next reading. Bye, guys.